and welcome back to another episode of Rippin' Packs. We are here at New York Comic Con with Joe Simcoe. Joe, we're so happy to be with you.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Describe Comic Con. I mean, the show is just massive.
It's great, yeah. It's very crowded and actually, amazingly, enough people where there's still room to walk around, you know, given the way things are nowadays.
Yeah, yeah. Absolutely. We've got a little elbow room this year, which is nice. Well, we're excited because we're going to rip open some GPK Chrome with you. Right. Now, for those at home, Garbage Pail Kids Chrome is really just a pickup of all of the original 80s cards. But from what I understand, Joe, you and the other three Garbage Pail Kids artists introduced some new characters into GPK Chrome with that chrome kind of theme behind it. Well, can you give us a little insight behind the characters?
Yeah, so myself, Brent Engstrom, Dave Gross, and Smokin' Joe, we got to do two new cards to add to the chrome set. We tried to keep that metallic, you know, very chrome feel. I've done a T-1000 before. Yep. Some of the guys, they'll do like a cowboy spitting into a metallic spittoon that has a GPK face on it. All the spit dripping everywhere.
Love it.
Yeah, so we all kind of just try to keep the theme going. And it's something that keeps it just a slightly more fresh and exciting for us to add something new to
Chase. Of course, you keep on innovating and keep on introducing characters, but enough talking about it. Let's rip some packs.
Oh my gosh, okay.
Let's do it. So grab a pack here. I'll rip them open. And Joe, I want to know how you got into Garbage Pail Kids. I know you were telling me that you were quite young when GPK originally came out. Can you tell us a little bit more about your background with GPK?
Sure. I mean, well, I was 10 years old in 1985 when Garbage Pail Kids first came out. I was buying them, you know, at the corner deli, grocery store, you know, 7-Eleven, gas stations, wherever they sold them. And yeah, collected. I was obsessed with them, like every kid that was in the 80s. And then when it stopped, I had also forgotten about it, you know, until I, you know, went to high school, went to college, and then noticed them started, like, when eBay, you know, the internet came out, and eBay was there and selling Garbage Pail Kid boxes, the original series. So, saw that, got all invigorated again, the excitement was back, and I started doing my own, I was always doing art and doing my own paintings, submitted some stuff to Topps, they brought me in, and... yeah, been there
since... The rest is history.
Yeah, the rest is history, since 2009.
Amazing. All right, well, I actually, out of my first pack here, I've got both A and B cards, which I love when you can pull A and B in the same pack.
Right on, yeah.
So here we go. We've got a Ferret Fossil and Dinosaur.
Right.
Both A and B cards.
Appropriately from the third series of, you know, from 1985.
There we go.
And who do I got? I got, well, this is a good metallic-y type one. I got Distorted Dot. Got the mirror action there. It's always good to have some, when the chrome really helps balance out the art there.
It does, yeah. I mean, when you go into designing these characters, knowing that it's gonna be in a chrome product, you know, artistically, what do you have to think of and what are you trying to convey in chrome? I mean, it's gotta be a little different than just your standard GPK stickers.
Well, no, it's true. And like I said, when I did a T-1000, the T-1000 wasn't with the chrome coating. It's the back of the card that actually has the chrome coating.
Sure.
But it still gives an interesting effect. And the outline even creates like this amazing like rainbow layer around the character, which maybe it's just like an offset of the printing.
Yeah,
but I mean, think it's a neat effect.
Yeah, it totally pops.
It pops the character out, yeah.
All right, let's see. Let's rip open another pack here. Let's
see if we find one of our new ones.
Here we go. Got a couple more A and B's in the same packs here. Silent Sandy, Baron Aaron, some really neat cards. Yeah. Ned Head, of course.
Ned Head, yes, yes.
Awesome. All right, we've got time for one more, so I'll let you do the honors.
Oh, okay. Well done, Sheldon. Thick Vic. Oh, here we go. Hothead Harvey. There's a good guy who could be a metallic. Actually, just to point out, this guy, Hothead Harvey, one of the iconic figures. We have a series of toys coming out, little figurines from the Loyal Subjects. So
amazing.
Look out for that one.
I mean, you know, GPK, of course, it started as stickers, but it's grown into so much more than that. It's,
you know,
geeky tiki mugs and the Crasher cars, right? I mean,
Tabasco sauce.
Tabasco sauce, you name it. Do you have
hot sauce?
Do you have like a favorite, you know, knickknack out of Garbage Pail Kids?
The cereal.
The cereal.
And I, you know, to do the cover. Although, I mean, every new project I get is like the next top favorite one. Like there's one I'm working on now. It's not going to come out until the end of 2022.
Okay. Okay.
Wish I could talk about.
All right. Well, that's all we're getting out of you here. But we are so excited for, you know, the rest of, to see your work, all the other three amazing artists at GPK. Thank you for ripping open some packs with us.
Thank you,
Emily. To everyone at home, be sure to check out the rest of our Topps video content at youtube.com/Topps Studios. And we'll see you next time.